Thank you very much. Thank you. Hope you enjoyed that, Single Girl. That's a number that my Uncle Carter used to sing years ago, and I recorded on the Carrying On CD, one of the Grammy-nominated albums, so we hope you enjoyed the version there tonight. I've had a few requests. I've had a lot of people, or not a lot of people, but probably four or five people met earlier back at the record table that said they've been hearing me on XM Sirius Radio and hearing a song called Bluefield. So how many of you folks here tonight have heard me sing Bluefield on the radio? Well, a few of you. Not too many. No wonder y'all are looking at me like, who in the world is that guy up there on the stage? No, this is a real good song, and I think it's one of my better songs I might have recorded so far. It's a good, I guess you call it a true story slash ballad, but with a little bit of a beat to it. And I have it recorded on my new CD back there, which is on my own record label, Stanley. It's called Stanley Family Records, and so I have a few copies with me, and I hope you enjoy this song enough to come back and get a CD off of me after a while. You know, I told you about John Rigsby CDs earlier, so many copies left. If you go back to the table tonight and you see John's CDs, he'll be sitting there with a pen in his hand and grinning like a possum. Just a good smile on his face. But what I want you to do is go up to him, shake his hand, see that pretty smile he's got. Come right over to my table and buy Born to be a Drifter off of me.
Ralph, what about Eddie's records? We hadn't told them about Eddie's records.
I was going to save them till the end.
Oh, you was? Okay, we'll tell them
All I know is just let your conscience be your guide.
here's a song, Bluefield. And Richard, I guess over here, I remember you especially. You bought one, and we'll do this for you, buddy, tonight. In the West Virginia hills, there must be 10,000 still. And they found the biggest one outside of Bluefield. A little peaceful country town, nothing else 4 miles around. I saw whiskey run like water down through Bluefield. My trouble started on that Tuesday afternoon. The sheriff told me federal men will be here soon. He said we come up with a plan to catch Bluefield's slickest man. And we will, as sure as I'm the sheriff of Bluefield. On a Wednesday I had 90 jars to cap. Didn't think they had the time to set a trap. In the brush I heard a sound, and I swiftly hit the ground. When I shot, I sent them running back to Bluefield. Not a soul suspected me. I was the sheriff's deputy. I make whiskey, but God knows I never kill. Didn't know he was that close when I let my shotgun go. But I found I killed my friend, the sheriff of Bluefield. I recall how mama and my girlfriend cried when they left with me for, oh no, what a try. It's my last night in this cell, the last story I will tell, as I sat on death row dreaming about Bluefield. Bluefield, Bluefield, oh, Bluefield. Thank you. Hope you enjoyed that.